Espinoza getting the leg up on the 6-5 favorite to win the Belmont Stakes.
Watch your back.
War Emblem. Can he do it? Can he become the 12th Triple Crown winner? The tension mounts. Horses make a turn of the walking ring in the paddock, then head to the track.
Start spreading the news. I'm leaving today. I wanna be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray and step around the heart of it. New York, New York. I wanna wake up in the city that doesn't sleep to find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. These little town blues are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. Come on, come through New York, New York.
The moment is at hand, and here for the call is Tom Durkin.
In 2.5 minutes, 12 furlongs from now, we will have a Triple Crown winner, or not, for the 24th consecutive year. The final horses moving into line for the 134th running of the Belmont Stakes. Perfect. War Emblem, very composed as he takes his spot in the starting gate for this final jewel of the Triple Crown. And 70-1 long shot, Sarava on the far outside. Sarava balking just momentarily. It's a field of 11. Ready for the start.
Getting close.
Of the Belmont Stakes. And they're off. And War Emblem's quest for the Triple Crown. He did not break alertly. War Emblem was off near the back of the pack. They race for the clubhouse turn, and Medaglia d'Oro is sent today. And Wiseman's Ferry toward the inside. And there goes War Emblem now, and he splits horses as they move into the first turn. He's now third in between horses. And then on the outside, it's Proud Citizen now ranging up to be fourth. Magic Wizener is fifth. Long Shot Sarava, sixth on the outside. Sunday Break, no better than seventh at this point. Perfect Drift is eighth on the outside. Then Artax 2, followed by Essence of Dubai. Like a Hero trails the field. War Emblem is fourth, and he's bottled up on the inside as they make their way into the backstretch. The first quarter in 24 seconds flat. Wiseman's Ferry leads the way into the backstretch. Medaglia d'Oro running in second. Proud Citizen on the outside. And they have effectively bottled up War Emblem. He is now fourth as they continue their run down the backstretch. Hard held is War Emblem. And then Sarava's right alongside him with 7/8 of a mile to go. Then there's a break of 2.5 lengths. Back to Magic Wisner. On the outside of him, Sunday Break. Perfect Drift. Just floating along comfortably. He's about 8 or 9 lengths from the lead. They continue up the backstretch. They're halfway home in the Belmont. The pace has been a sensible one. 3/4 and 12 and 1. And there's an inviting opening at the inside for War Emblem. And he's making his move with 5 furlongs to go. War Emblem, Medaglia d'Oro now heads apart for the lead. Wiseman's Ferry is tailing off now. Proud Citizen is poised on the outside. Sunday Break has come alive. 4 furlongs to go. Medaglia d'Oro in an all-out battle here with War Emblem. Medaglia d'Oro by a neck. War Emblem, Proud Citizen looms a threat. He's on the outside third with 3 furlongs to go. Sarava, the big long shot, is winning in fourth. Sunday Break is fifth. Magic Wisner beginning to move up now on the outside. He's 7 lengths from the lead. And War Emblem is toiling as they turn for home. Medaglia d'Oro, Sunday Break. Sarava has come on through to take the lead. And War Emblem has given way. No Triple Crown for the 24th year. Here comes Sarava and Medaglia d'Oro, though, striding to the line together. Sarava on the outside. Medaglia d'Oro toward the rail. They're coming down to the finish.
finish. A huge upset is looming here under the line. Sarava has won the biggest long shot in the history of the Belmont Stakes at 70-1. Medaglia was finishing second there. And farther back, Sunday Break. And a huge disappointment today for War Emblem. He was off poorly, never got rolling, and faded in the stretch. So once again, the Triple Crown will go unclaimed, but a worthy winner today in Sarava.
No Triple Crown is Sarava, $142.50, $50.22.40. The biggest upset since Sherlock, $132 in 1961. As the garland of white carnations goes over the withers of Sarava, Ken McPeek with his back to you there, and his wife Sue off to his left. What an upset. Sarava had only had one stake start. He won the Sir Barton Stakes at Pimlico on Preakness Day. Comes back to take the test of a champion. Edgar Prado celebrates his first win in four Belmont tries.
Our job,